Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss CMOS and nano scaling. This is a topic which comes under third unit of nano electronics of sixth semester EC students. What we mean by scaling? Scaling is a parameter or a process by which we try to make any device more compatible. Before discussing scaling, one must know what is Moore's law. Moore's law is developed in 1965 by Jordan Moore. He gives an exponential growth of number of transistors with respect to the number of years. Like he started evaluating from 1959, 1975 and so on till now also. And here gradually number of transistors are enhancing exponentially. This law gives the knowledge that as the years are passing through, the number of size of device is becoming compact and number of component is enhancing. This is a very important law and backbone of VLSI, ULSI and nanoscale. Now as far as scaling is concerned, whether it is a CMOS or a nanoscale, means 10 to the power minus 6 or minus 9, there are certain factors. Like first is dimensions. Dimension means W is a width, L is a length, T0X is thickness. Voltage, VDD is a supply, doping level. These are called constant field scaling. Constant field scaling means these parameters are constant with respect to their fields. Lateral scaling only gate length, often done as quick as shrink. That is, S is a scaling parameter and generally we consider its value is 1.0. Now this table is a summary table of with respect to the scaling. Mainly scaling parameters are length, width, gate oxide thickness, that is T0X, supply voltage, that is VDD, threshold voltage, VTN, VTP, substrate doping, that is NA. With respect to this, the scaling factor variation with a constant field, it is 1 by S except NA. And for a lateral scaling, it is length is 1 by S, remaining are 1. As far as device characteristics are concerned, in that category, beta, IDS, that is drain to source current, resistance, gate capacitance, gate delay, that is called tau, clock frequency, F, dynamic power dissipation, that is P, chip area, power density, current density. Their formulas are beta is nothing but W by L 1 upon T0X. The scaling factor for a constant and lateral field. See, I explained you what we mean by constant and lateral scaling. Fine. That is same as S. For IDS, the value for the saturation region. That is beta VDD minus VTK square. For a non-saturation, what is the formula? That is a beta VDS minus VGS by 2 minus VDS square by 2. That is the formula which is going to use for the non-saturation region. And the values with reference to constant and lateral field is 1 by S and S. Resistance, that is VDD by IDSS. For a constant field it is 1. For a lateral scaling factor is 1 by S. Similar way, the capacitance value is there. Gate delay values is there. Clock frequency, that is 1 upon tau. Power dissipation, CV square upon F. And their scaling is also going to be changed with respect to 1 upon S square. Chip area, power density, current density. Fine. Power density is P upon A and current density IDS upon A. Many students make mistake while evaluating this both the density in the CMOS scaling. After this scaling, that is a particular device characteristic scaling. Apart from this, one more scaling is there, that is called interconnect characteristic scaling. Influence of scaling on interconnect characteristic. That is a particular scaling which plays its vital role when I am connecting one MOS with another MOS or a staggered sort of MOSes. In this, our scaling parameters are width, that is W. That is 1 by S scaling factor, spacing between two interconnects, that is S with reference to this 1 upon S, interlayer oxide height, that is going to be 1 upon S and 1. Thickness that is going to vary by 1 by S. Characteristic per unit length, if we talk about this, then we have a certain parameters like wire resistance per unit length RW, that is sensitivity of this. Look at here, scaling parameter which are nominal, their sensitivity is nothing. But as far as per unit length parameter came into the account, as far as interconnect characteristics are concerned, their sensitivities parameters are going to be there. With respect to this, we have the reduced thickness and constant thickness. So for RW, it is 1 upon WT. What is my T? T is a thickness, W is a width. So 1 upon width multiplied by thickness, and their variation is like this. Fringing capacitor per unit length, that is C omega F, that is T upon S. Fine. Parallel plate capacitance per unit length, it is W upon H, and their changes are like this. CW is nothing but total wire capacitance per unit length, that is C omega F plus C omega P, that is 1 and between 1 and S. Similarly, there are other parameters like crosstalk noise, unrepeated RC constant per unit length, repeated wire RC delay per unit length, and their variations is like this. These both the tables are the backbone for the scaling of the CMOS devices and interconnect characteristic. Thank you so much.